This is Supply Raid on Legendary Difficulty, and I want to show you a technique that I have employed here that I think is a very good technique. And what I've done is I've crossed the river to the west, and I've taken up the high ground on the south, and I'm just luring the enemy into attacking me. This is a pretty easy battle. It's a little bit frustrating because your weapons are terrible, and so you shoot the enemy over and over again, and you do very little damage. So you have, it's just an endless grindy exercise of just taking 10,000 shots on the enemy. But if you do it, with particularly dismounted, you just take shot after shot after shot on the enemy and you ground them down. And you degrade them, you degrade their morale, their condition, even though you're only doing like, I don't know, 5 to 10 damage each shot. I mean, it's just not very much. And dismounted cav is difficult to manage. It wants to bounce all over the place, and it's difficult to control. Dismounted cav is easier to control than mounted. Mounted just, it's like herding cats, man. It just does not want to do what you tell it to do. But mounted cav is good if you have to counterattack. Like right now, I want to counterattack this guy. Mounted cav is good for that. But as you can see, the enemy's taking hits and he's going to fall back. And this is just, like, it just feels like hours of the enemy attacking and you just hitting him. So that's all we're doing here. We're just luring him into the water, taking shots on him, slowly grinding him down. It's actually pretty easy, even on Legendary, it's pretty easy. You're outnumbered 2-to-1. Being outnumbered 2-to-1 on Legendary is normal. And it's pretty easy victory. Now, the first time I fought this, I just attacked at the flag and took it. But not much of the enemy survived, so I reloaded. I have a video on the results. The first time the enemy got a big buff to manpower. The second time he got a huge buff of 13 to training, which I'm very concerned about because training was already high. But Pandakraut says that after a certain point, it probably doesn't matter. After about 70 training, the enemy just can't go up any higher. That might be true. We're going to find out because apparently we're on our way to 150 training if, you know, things continue on the way they have been. So I'll be able to do an experiment on that. So anyway, keep fighting the battle. Keep chipping away at the enemy. We're on the left side of the map. We're on the bottom of the map. I've abandoned the right side of the map. But the point of this is to show you that this is what I would call phase one. And in phase one, we're just going to, you know, if his infantry comes forward, we're going to chip away at it. If his cab comes forward, we're going to chip away at it. But at some point, his cab is going to be taken out of the battle as a force. He's just going to keep attacking. We're try to stay in the woods, try to stay in cover, try to stay, you know, in support of artillery. Like we have two batteries here. One is a 10-pound Parrot. The other one is, like, there, his unit just dissolved. Try to get 2-to-1, two units on one, so you get the huge melee buff. And just patiently chip at him and destroy his units one at a time. And then at a certain point, which is, you know, he clearly is less enthusiastic about charging. He's not going to give you any more opportunities to kill units and catch units in the water. And what I do is, you can see, I'm telling everybody across the water, we're going to come back to the center. It just takes a moment, get everybody there. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put, now you can leave one or two units on the other side of the river. That wouldn't be bad. That might work out. But on Legendary, I probably need everybody to make this move. And the neat thing about Cav is, you know, they can run all over the map and they don't get tired. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to the right side of the map with most of our army and occupy the woods that are on the right side of the map. And we're going to approach the flag from that direction. And the reason is that we can get a lot of what we can actually wipe the enemy out and not trip the flag. It's very easy to do from that angle. It's harder to do if you attack from right here where the army is, you're going to trip the flag because he's going to back up on to the other side of the flag, and it's, you can do it, but it's kind of a nuisance. You can get to him, but it's a bit harder. He has troops to, as we're looking at the map, to the right. He probably will have someone in that little farmhouse. There's a hidden location there that he he can occupy where you won't see him. It's a unique feature of just this battle. And so you have a real obstacle on both flanks. You have the flag right in front of you that you don't want to trip. I mean, it's just harder to do, I think. So what I'm going to do is drive these guys back here, hurt them, but get my army moving to the right, cross the river, and come up on the right side, occupy the woods on the right. And as you'll see, that's the angle of approach that we're going to have to wipe him out. He's vulnerable that way, even though that's low ground, and I usually try to avoid low ground. It's a very easy victory, and it's really easy to wipe him out and not trip the flag if you go that way. So, yeah, it's kind of unfortunate that this is all about not tripping the flag. You know, that's something you have to do. If you want to wipe them out, you have to not trip the stupid flag. It'd be nice if you could take the flag and the battle would still give you the option to go on and wipe them out, but it doesn't. So, yeah, moving everybody to the right. I move the 10-pound parrots a little bit to the right, kind of get them across from the little, farmhouse. And then I stop. I could have just left them at the top of the hill. The 10-pound parrot, of course, does best at range. The right at the end of its range is the peak of the damage that it does, so he could have just stayed. I keep at least three cav on the top of the hill, and everybody else moves to the south. So I want to take these woods first, and yeah, the little farmhouse is going to have two units, one of them an infantry unit, and then I'm going to take the woods north of this position, and everybody moves forward. And I have four units, and five units, and an artillery still to the south, and their job is going to be to, you know, close in on the flank of anybody that becomes a target. So, yeah, this works out real well. You have good cover in the woods, even though we have the low ground position. We can defend this and take very few casualties. The AI is not going to do well in these exchanges. Even if he charges into the woods, his units, you know, the first phase, we've degraded his army to the point that he just does not have as much fight. You know, that cav unit attacked and he got wiped out. He was already cut down to size. So he's going to recharge his charge meter. And when he does, he's going to be easy to kill. And we're going to be able to put pressure on him and get to him. See, there's several infantry units and a couple of artillery units on the other side of that flag, and I want to get them without tripping the flag. That's the whole thing. And we're going to be able to do that, as you're going to see. This is actually pretty easy. Just don't trip the flag. And keep pushing everybody kind of north. And the guys in the south can advance, but if they advance, they either need to break right or left so that they're not near the victory location. And, we don't trip the flag, so it all works out. Yeah, he can't win this. This is just a matter of time. So, in the woods to the north, I only have one unit kind of spotting, keeping an eye on things. And as soon as this position is secured, then another unit needs to go over there, maybe two or three units in. Yeah, I think three units is probably the right unit, right number on the north edge, because that's where the artillery is. And the more folks you have over there, the more shots you're going to get at his artillery. So, yeah, the battle goes on. I attacked to the north and I cut that out. That his artillery was up there, and my artillery just went unopposed right into his artillery and took shots on it and routed it and pretty much killed it. My guys to the south broke to the left, and they're just having a party over there. Yeah, his army just broke up into different parts and routed in strange directions, and now it's just run everybody down and kill him. And yeah, I forget how many minutes you get once you take the flag. And we might be about to take it. So I think from memory, I can't remember the exact time. And it's on, you can Google it and look it up. But as I played this, I was aware of the time. And I'm looking at the time right now, and I must have been thinking, well, I need to take the flag anyway. It's getting to be about 12:40, time to take the flag. And I've done enough. I mean, if I can kill more, great. But if I can't, that's fine. So I have 30 minutes in game to wrap this up. And yeah, they're just tiny remnants of an army. Captured the supply wagon, and he has some battered and beaten units, and we're going to kill those. And that's it. Now, at the end of this battle, his training went up 13 points, so I didn't take this result. I took the previous result where I didn't kill them all, where a couple thousand of them got away, and his manpower went up. I don't know which one would have been better. The enemy was, all 3 stars, all legendary type units, legendary difficulty, exactly what I expected. Very hyper aggressive. Every shot hurt, did extra damage. It felt like his artillery was very, very deadly because they had unit perks and 3 stars. So would it have been harder if training was up 10 more points? I don't know. But we're gonna find out because after Chancellorsville, even though his army gets wiped out, training just keeps going up. So we're running an experiment to see how high we can get training. Yeah, this is an interesting battle and kind of fun, but because none of the units are mine, it's hard for me to get that much into it. I want to build my army, and there's always an event here where he goes up. Now I know in man his manpower pool is going to jump, or his training is going to jump significantly, or his armory is going to jump. And Pandekraut says that there are kind of triggered things in the game, that there is a calculation. If something is particularly low, then a jump in that trait can go up, can happen. And the amount of the change is affected by the level of difficulty. So yeah, this is great. Good result. Happy with it. Got them all, as you can see. Here are the results. Very interesting. One of my artillery batteries did the best, probably because it had the best weapons. Yeah. The enemy had Lamotts, no surprise. And in this battle, he goes up quite a bit in training. Now he's at 81 to 86. So I take the first version, and he only goes up in manpower. And I'll see you in the next battle. Thanks.